Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to Lightning Gaming. So in today's episode we'll be building the easiest melee only horde base possible in 7 days to die. Now guys, this base will be indestructible, it's gonna be melee weapons only, no ranged weapons required. So first up, you just place 3 blocks and you pillar all 3 of them up, at least 15 blocks, but the higher the better. Once you're done, you're gonna add a ladder to each and every one of the pillars. So you're gonna put the ladder on every block here on this 3 block pillar, and you're gonna take all of these ladders all the way to the top. Once you're done guys, we're gonna start here at the bottom. We're gonna put up a little force field on the inside. So you're just gonna need a pickaxe or auger or whatever tools you have for taking out the blocks, and you're just gonna dig out 1 block all the way around. Just do these 2 blocks over here as well, and then the same on the other side. I'm running out of stem, I'm just gonna use light attacks. Okay, so just 2 more blocks this side as well. One over here, right next to the pillar. And then one here in the corner. Okay, so once you're done taking out those blocks, we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna put up the force field, which is basically right over here, and it's the half cube holes, and you're just gonna rotate it upside down. Now guys, what this means is the zombies can't get to the pillar from this side. They can only get up by the ladders. They can't attack your pillar. Now to make sure they don't fall inside the half holes, what sometimes happens, you're just gonna put up some ramps. Now guys, what's gonna happen if they fall on the ramp? They're just gonna ragdoll off and they won't fall inside the hole, which well, if they fall inside the hole, they will be stuck there and they'll attack your structure. So if you put these ramps up, they won't be able to fall inside. They're just gonna ragdoll right over the circles. So once you're done guys, you're gonna leave at least 8 blocks open, and then you're gonna pillar up once again to the same height as the previous pillar. So let's just go all the way up. Okay, so once you're done pillaring up 3 blocks guys, we're just gonna make it a little bigger here up at the top, because this is where we'll be standing with our melee weapon. So I would say at least 3 blocks, but the more space you want, the better you can do it. You can even add in more pillars if you want a more spacious horde base, but yeah, like this is fine, it will work. I'm gonna do the same on this side. Now guys, I know what you're thinking, vultures are gonna attack this thing, but if you put up some spikes at the top, the vultures will almost die instantly. So vultures won't really be a problem. Okay, so now you're just gonna go ahead and you're gonna build the walls like this. Now stack this up as high as you want. You must at least be able to stand inside the horde base. Once you're done with the walls and the roof, you're just gonna fall back down. Now we're gonna take some construction okay, I'm just gonna finish up the force field on this side as well. Now guys, on this side you're gonna put up the force field all around. I'm just gonna skip through that real quick because I did show you how to do it in the previous pillar. Okay, so we've got our force field up all around. Now we're just gonna add in some more ramps on the inside to ensure zombies don't fall into our force field and break our structure. So we'll just be adding a couple more ramps. I'm gonna do it the same height as the previous one. The next block, there we go, just rotate it so they react all away from our force field. Okay, so that's basically it for the build guys. Now I'm just gonna complete the dropper. It won't be a wet 60 dropper. The wet 60 dropper just doesn't work well for a melee horde base. I'm gonna fall off. Okay, I fell off. I'm just gonna pillar up all over again. Now guys, I'm using construction blocks because I want to be able to pick it back up after I finish the horde base. So yeah, basically you're just gonna pillar up till you reach the same height as your 2 pillars. Now I'm going to switch back to my steel blocks. I'm gonna go to poles. I'm gonna use the middle pole. Then I'm just gonna rotate it so that it's at the top of our 3 blocks. There we go. Now we're just gonna take this straight through. Start from this side as well. Okay, and yeah, let me just connect the two real quick. Okay, so zombies will run over this guys, they won't be able to crowd you, they're gonna fall off if they all both try to stand on the same block at the same time. So now I'm just removing all the construction blocks. Now for the final part of the horde base guys, let me just head up there real quick. Now this part is the most important, cause if you can't kill the zombie, he's gonna run and he's gonna fall off. starting the loop all over again. So all you're gonna do is you're just gonna take the ramp frame. You're gonna place one here right on top of the pole. Let me just rotate it in position real quick. Almost there, almost there. Okay, there we go. So you're gonna place him just like this, another one at the top. And then you're just gonna place some double poles in the middle to ensure nothing can crawl through. There's the double poles. Let me just place these real quick. Okay, there we go. Okay, so the horde base is finished, guys, and we can go enjoy the horde night. I'm gonna show you how that works out real quick. I just want to fix this. I've placed this block so ugly over here because I just wanted to save some time. But yeah, let me just fix it so that it at least looks decent. Okay, so finally time for horde night, guys. Now let me show you the best melee horde base on 7 Days to Die right now. You're gonna be able to use any melee weapon you want, guys. You're gonna hit. I like to use the stun baton because I like to knock off multiples. But if you use something like a sledgehammer, you're gonna be able to kill almost every zombie. But yeah, the ones that falls down, they're gonna run all the way around, climb back up the ladder and do this all over again. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the video, please remember to give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. Till next time, guys. Cheers. See ya.